Right, so that's how you wreck a bucket. You're never supposed to do that ever with a bucket. That's not how you use a bucket. But we all do that sometimes, and this time it didn't work. I was just gonna try to see if I could make the boulder move to see if it was stuck or if it was even bedrock, basically, because you never know. There might be peaks sticking up here. But it looks like it's just a very big boulder. And so we're gonna try to weld this together. I'm gonna try to beat it with a hammer and see if I can get it to get closer here. And we're just gonna try to burn it together here on both sides to see if that works. So I noticed now when I was cleaning it, cleaning off all the dirt, there's actually an old crack because you can see there's rust here on the surface of the crack, but not here. This is fresh. This is what I did now, and there has already been a crack, which of course made it easier to break it now. It was already going, and but that doesn't matter. It's not an excuse. You're never supposed to use a bucket like that anyway, so. So it doesn't work by just hammering this. It's too stiff, so I have to heat it, but I don't have any acetylene, so I have to use propane, and it's not for heating stuff, it's for making it a little bit warmer. It takes forever to heat something up with this. It's for cooking sausages, not for melting metal. So yeah, I'm gonna try it at least. I don't know if this is enough for. I think I have another can of propane as well, so. But I need to try that, so. Right, so I've tried welding it together the first run, and I'm gonna do the other side, and then I have to lay it down on the side because it's hard to weld on a vertical surface because the weld kind of wants to flow down. So I'm gonna just lay it on the side and try to weld it like that, just to kind of add some more material and then just smooth it off. But it's really hard to do these kind of welds they always get kind of wonky, but I think it will hold